What's going on, guys? Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. My name is Boo78. Hopefully you guys are doing well today, by the way. And we are here in Phoenix, Arizona, in the Kenworth W900. Taking a load here out of Walmart. Take a look at the manifest real quick. We got 39,000 pounds of frozen vegetables going up to Ely, Nevada, to the Walmart up there. So this will be a nice long run for us. Take a look at the route here. And pretty much the only way we can go. Wish there was a way I could get around Vegas, but we'll just deal with that, I guess. Don't know what it is about Vegas, but it seems like I have the worst luck in that city. But take a quick look at the truck here. I used this the other day in a gameplay video. I've not really done a whole lot to it for quite a while, but I did get it updated enough to where I can use it in some content here on the channel. After I get the T680 done, and I'll probably work on it a little bit, you know, while I'm still working on that. Kind of go back and forth between the two, honestly, but I want to get this updated and get this released as well. But I know I've been saying that for a while, but we will get that done sooner or later. And of course, we got the utility reefer behind us from the Steam Workshop there. The engine mod I'm using today is by Creechbaum. It is the Cummins N14 chipped. I believe it's the 610 horsepower. Then using an 18-speed Eaton Fuller transmission with 355s. You know, like I said before, that is kind of my go-to transmission. Still using DP's traffic mod, and I'm kind of on the fence as to whether to take that out or not. At the very least, I thought about taking it out till maybe some updates came along for it. The only issue I really have with this mod is when you're going down the highway and traffic just kind of stops out of nowhere. You know, I don't mind the the fact there's a little bit more traffic and stuff like that. I think that makes it a lot more realistic. But just the part where, traffic comes to like a dead stop in the middle of the interstate, that happens a little too frequent. At least for me it does. I don't know. Maybe you guys have a little bit better success, better luck with it than I do, but it seems like more often than not, like every time I sit down to play, I'm having to, dodge traffic and make some evasive maneuvers. Intersection here. I'm glad to be back in the W900 though. I really did miss this truck. Just like having that long hood out there, and the SEI steering wheel is pretty sweet too. Got the hood fixed, so I'm happy about that. Back when I updated it for 1.4, the mapping was all messed up on the hood, so half the hood was one color, the other half was another color. Yeah. Oh. Well, there's no rhyme or reason to this intersection here, so we're just gonna go. Beautiful looking sunrise this morning here in Phoenix. Should make for a great start for our day as we trek up north. I don't know, this trip up to Ely's one of my favorites though. Usually a pretty solid run. and this is another thing with the traffic mod, it can be a little bit difficult from time to time to get out on the highway there. And maybe if I scooch up there a little bit further, that'll kind of... Yeah, we should be able to go now. Sure, what this guy is doing up here. Sure, the Digger 5000 is a little bit heavy, but come on now. Should have had that thing wound up by now. Get up here and get around this gutless wonder. We got things to do today. Ain't no time for that. Ain't no time for that guy. Drop back down to 65 and we should be good to go. You guys probably noticed I changed the colors up on this again. This is going to be the final colors for this truck. Really, really like the way it looks. I think it just makes it just stand out. I think it really gives it a good look. That two-tone gray, kind of a light gray. Hop out here and take a look and see if I can't kill anything. I don't know, just think it looks really good. And kind of one thing I need to do for this truck when I do release it is this cab, this particular cab here is going to have to be added as a separate cab, because to get the skin to work, I had to change the UV mapping and Z modeler, which what that did was it made all the other default skins not work on the truck. So I'll have to fix that just by adding, you know, this as an additional cab variant. So, but that'll all be spelled out and all that good stuff. But no timetable for any kind of releases or anything like that. It's just going to be, you know, kind of when I get them done and, you know, stuff like that. Come on, people, seriously? That's kind of what I'm talking about. You know, I get the traffic's congested and stuff like that, but man, why is it just, why is the AI just kind of stopping like that out of nowhere? You know, luckily we were able to get stopped and didn't have to run off on the shoulder or anything like that, but... And again, I understand that stuff happens in real life. You know, it should happen in the game as well, but I think it just happens a little too frequent, at least for my taste. Jake Brake is just sick sounding. I love that. All Creech Bomb does a fantastic job there of with his sound mods, and apparently somewhere along the way I missed an exit. Not a big deal though. I was paying more attention to the traffic than I was the HUD there, so. Not a big deal. Let's get turned around here. I think we just missed it just by just a little bit there, so it's not like we're gonna have to trek back too far. So I thought that was thought I seen a fuel stop down there, but guess not. So I kind of glanced that available billboard just real quick and thought there was a fuel station down there. Not a huge deal though. I mean, we got plenty of fuel. Just enough someone to let us out. Probably not. Probably not. We'll just hit this exit down here and get back on track. Sounds all sorts of good. There is a fuel stop over there, so I think we'll hit that before we go down the highway. We don't have, shouldn't have to worry about fuel the rest of the trip. Kind of scroll around there and look at the truck. There we go, all fueled up. And away we go. Not what I wanted. Yeah, looks like we're doing pretty good on rest. Glad that's done and out of the way. I don't have to worry about that. Just get out here, hammer down, and point this thing north. Change the pace here, doing some two-lane driving. So there's usually a pretty fair amount of that on this particular stretch, so on this run up to Ely. Took that a little bit faster than I care for. Starting to drive like the AI now, that's kind of scary. Really heard any major news here lately for ATS, so I'm hoping we get something soon. Start get that fuel mileage to go up there a little bit this run. Might be a little bit tough going up north with all these hills and everything though. Got it sorted out or got it figured out or whatever, but the whole darkness issue doesn't seem to be as bad since I reinstalled the drivers and kind of tweaked my inspector profile a little bit. Now we'll wait for that guy there. And the next guy. But not for Publix. I will not wait for him. After I had to reinstall a couple things, and the Windows 10 updated, for whatever reason, I don't know why it does this, but sometimes it will, sometimes it won't, but for whatever reason, it kind of wiped out all my Logitech G920 settings. So I had to go back and kind of tweak those a little bit again. Pretty sure I got everything set back to where it was. Couldn't remember exactly offhand where everything was, so. That all seems good now. Like that, might have to tinker with it a little bit in Zmod to get that all sorted out, but added a dashboard color mod, so that way it changes up, it matches the color of your truck, so that's kind of cool. Chris over on Truck Mod Shop released that. Link for that will be down in the video description. I think it looks kind of cool. It kind of matches the truck and everything, so kind of gives it a little bit more of that custom feel, that personal touch, if you will. Too fast down the hill there. A little too fast. That's okay. We're good. Since the rescale has been out just a little while now, I thought about kind of sitting down and thinking about like a post rescale release kind of wish list of some things that I like to see added to the game. I don't know. What are some things you guys would like to see added? Maybe some additional features and things like that. Things we don't have in the game yet. I think trailer ownership would definitely be at the top of the list. I just really don't understand why that has not made it into the game yet. I think that would be at the top of my list for sure. A couple other things I'd like to see. like some kind of option where you can save, you know, tire and wheel presets. You know, if you have, you know, like a specific set of wheels and hubs and, you know, all that stuff that you use all the time, it'd be nice to be able to just kind of have that saved as a preset. That way, when you're customizing a truck or something like that, using a new truck, whatever, you don't have to go through and, you know, go through that process, you know, six different times. You can just hit a button, boom, there you go. There's the wheel setup that you use. I think that brake sensitivity is a lot better now. Might tweak it just a little bit more, make it a little less sensitive, but overall I think it's not too bad. We should be getting pretty close to Vegas. Yeah, not too far. We're going through Kingman here. I'm not sure how all this plays out with licensing and things like that, because apparently that still appears to be a bit of a hurdle that SES has been facing, is the licensing for trucks. But it'd be nice if, you know, we're not going to get any new trucks, you know, anytime soon, if they could somehow go back and give us different variants of the trucks, you know, kind of like I'm doing with the T680. That'd be nice to see them go back and do something similar, you know. And same thing with the 579. Give us some different options. I know a couple of you guys recognize Peterbilt Steve there on YouTube, Steve Carboni. You know, give us a version of, you know, something like that. A larger sleeper. Just give us some more, you know, stock options. I think that'd be pretty cool. You know, give us some flat top options for the 680 and the 579 and the W900 for that matter. Like I said, I'm not sure how all that plays out with licensing. So I think that'd be pretty cool. And someone even threw out in the comment section the other day, they were asking about the utility reefer, and they mentioned that it'd be cool if SES would, you know, release, you know, something like the utility reefer. Like actual name trailers, I think is kind of what they were alluding to. At least that's kind of what I took from it. That would be pretty cool. I know I've talked about that in the past. That'd be really cool to see him come out with actual name trailers. And it seems like they're, you know, slowly but surely kind of making progress on building relationships with some of these big manufacturers. You know, seeing they did a DLC for ETS2 to where it was like a Michelin fan pack, Michelin tire fan pack. Which, you know, most people probably see that, like, nah, who cares, that's, you know, that's no big deal. But it kind of is, because, I mean, Michelin's a huge, you know, one of the biggest tire manufacturers in the world. And for them to be working with SES is, you know, kind of a big deal. You know, hopefully that kind of opens up some other doors for them and maybe helps with that licensing thing. I don't know. Gotta try to keep my distance from traffic here. Kind of seems like one of those prime moments for traffic just to kind of stop dead in its tracks here, so gotta give myself enough room here. Undoubtedly one of the more beautiful parts of the game right here. Yep. Knew that was coming. I can't remember exactly what it is, but I thought it was like law or something like that. You had to, you know, if you were under like 30, 35 miles an hour or something like that, had to have your four-ways on, or you're supposed to have your four-ways on. Or it could be just like a courteous thing, courtesy thing, I don't know, but that's why I do that. El Hoover Dam. Good grief almighty, come on. I'll turn that cop into a pancake. If not for little things like that, this traffic mod would be just about perfect. But, and like I said, I don't know if it's necessarily the traffic mod, or if it's just the AI in general. Good God. There we go. Vegas. But like I said, I don't know if it's the DP traffic mod that does that, or if it's just the AI traffic in general, but I think just in general, the AI traffic still needs a little bit of tweaking. I think it's still a little bit crazy. Could use a little bit more work. See, yeah, it's about time to find us a place to park. And yeah, looks like we should have one. It's right there, so we'll set that. I know this one's running a little bit long. Be right about 40 minutes or so. So I'm trying to keep the episodes right to about 30 minutes. That seems to be where you guys like them. Actually, I took a poll there on Twitter about a week or so ago, and it was pretty much, you know, right around anywhere 25, 30 minutes was kind of what you guys want to see. So do what I can to try to keep them there. Sometimes it might run long, sometimes it might run a little bit short, but I'll kind of target that 30 minutes. And it looks like traffic's kind of light in Vegas right now, so I will take it. Probably could have made it through that, but What do you do? Catch that red light too, so I'm gonna go ahead and continue down to the motel, get some rest, but I'm gonna go ahead and call it for right now. If you like today's video, just give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, and consider subscribing now. But guys, until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing ya.